Hallelujah to all those joining us today. We bless the Lord for you. We thank you for always keeping us company every other morning. And this is yet another day that God has given to us. I want us to pray. Then we'll go to the Word, and then we pray the Word, as is our custom. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless and glorify your name. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be exalted. You're worthy to be magnified this morning. We appreciate you this morning. We glorify your name this morning. We magnify that great name of Jesus. We pray, O God, that you be exalted in our midst. We pray, O God, that receive the highest praise, receive the highest glory. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be exalted. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Yes, one more time. Thank you for joining us this morning. Thank you for taking time just to connect with us so that we can pray and we can seek the face of God. We are in Colossians. Colossians chapter number 1. That's our focus. I want us to read as we did yesterday. As we were praying, we read the scripture in Psalm chapter number 18, and then we pray today. We are reading Colossians chapter number 1. I'm giving you an opportunity to read there so that we can be together. This week we will be opening scriptures and praying through the scriptures. I believe that when we pray through the scriptures, we are edified. When we pray through the scriptures, we are strengthened. Colossians chapter number 1. The Bible says from verse number 1, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to God's holy people in Colossae, the faithful brothers and sisters in Christ. Grace and peace to you from God our Father. Verse number 3, are we together? We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you, because we have had of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love you have for all the people. The faith and love that spring from the hope stored up for you in heaven, and about which you have already heard in the true message of the gospel that has come to you. In the same way, the gospel is bearing fruit and growing throughout the whole world, just as it has been doing among you since the day you heard it and truly understood God's grace. You learned it from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is a faithful minister of Christ on our behalf, and who also told us of your love in the Spirit. Let's continue verse number 9. For this reason, since the day we heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and pleasing in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience, and giving joyful thanks to the Father, who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of his holy people in the kingdom of light. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of his Son, of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. So we are praying Colossians chapter 1 prayer. We shall be moving together as we did yesterday, and I believe that the grace and the mercy of God will be with us even as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So I want us to start right there as we pray. Remember, we are praying the scriptures. The more we pray the scriptures, the better we are. The more we pray the scriptures, the better we are. And I want us to start from verse number 2. The Bible says, grace and peace to God's holy people in Colossae, the faithful brothers and sisters in Christ. Grace and peace to you. Grace and peace. Grace and peace. We are praying that the grace of God will be multiplied in our midst. And peace, the peace of God at such a time as this will be multiplied. And then we continue from verse number 3. We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you. We always thank God. Thanksgiving will emanate from our spirit today. Because as we pray for brothers and sisters, as we pray for the church, as we pray for this world, that we are thankful people. Verse number 4, because we heard of your faith, we are believing God that the people we are praying for, they are believing God in faith. And the people who don't have the faith in God, we are believing God that God is bringing salvation into their hearts in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You see, ladies and gentlemen, every time we pray the scriptures, there are things that open up. There are things that open up that we could not have prayed for. And as we pray the scriptures, it becomes our prayer becomes solid. It becomes rich like never before. So I want us to start praying. And even as we pray, of course, you'll be hearing us as I lead. We keep on praying. Remember, we are in this journey together. I am praying, you're praying, you're praying, I am praying. Together we are praying. Together we get the victory, we get the success, we get our healing, we get our breakthrough by the grace of God. So just take some time and start praying. Pray the scriptures. Open up your Bible. We are praying the scriptures. We are praying the scripture. This week, yesterday we prayed Psalm chapter 18. Today we are in Colossians chapter number 1. Just praying the scriptures and praying. And our lives are being nourished. Our families are being nourished even as we pray the scriptures today in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Prayer is sweet. And that's why I'm excited every time I have the opportunity to lead us in prayer. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, yes, for yet another opportunity that you have given to us as a people. Thank you, God, for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Yeah, yesterday is gone. Today is a new day that your grace and mercy are new, God. Thank you for the strength in prayer. Thank you for the intelligence in prayer. Thank you for the grace to be able to pray your heart and your will at such a time as this. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, we thank you that in this session, as we pray fast, according to Colossians chapter number 1, Father, we pray, oh God, that Lord, you guide us. We pray that you lead us. We pray, oh God, that through the scriptures, oh God, that there is your breathing life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, some of us, it is our first time to be able to pray the scriptures, that this week, oh God, we feel strange of how we are praying the scriptures. But Father, I pray that may we grow as we pray the scriptures. May we grow in the word. May we grow in prayer. May we grow in intercession as we are praying the scriptures. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, Lord, today we thank you, God, for grace and peace that is being multiplied. Even as we pray today, as your word says in Colossians chapter number 1, verse number 2, grace and peace be to you from God our Father. Today, as we pray, Father, I pray for my brother, I pray for my sister, I pray for grace and peace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the double portion that is being bestowed upon their lives as they pray in Jesus' name, that is not coming from man but is coming from you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May they experience that grace, may they experience the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Those that are in turmoil today, I pray with them, may grace and peace be multiplied. Our families, oh God, that are on a shaking ground, I pray for them today. May grace and peace from God our Father be unto you in Jesus' name. Businesses that are not progressing, I pray for you today. May grace and peace that is coming from God our Father be unto you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lives that don't know what to do this week, may grace and peace be unto you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I thank you because you are the source of our grace. We swim in grace because this grace is never depleted. We swim in peace because the peace that comes from God surpasses all human understanding. The peace of God that causes us, oh God, to be stronger even in the storm. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God, I pray, oh God, for my brother and my sister. They are in the prayer closet today. My God, some of them don't have even the strength to pray. Some of them don't know what to do, my God. Some of them don't know how to utter this prayer, but today I pray, may the grace of God, may the grace of God Hold their lives in Jesus' name. May the grace of God hold them stronger. May the grace of God enable them to pray through. You say, oh God, that the spirit of grace and supplication is usually poured from your throne. I pray for the spirit of grace and supplication today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, Colossians chapter number 1, verse number 2. May grace and peace be to the saints. May grace and peace be to the intercessors today. May grace and peace be to the fathers today. May grace and peace be to the mothers today. May grace and peace be to the clergy today. May grace and peace be to the laity today. May grace and peace be to the sons and daughters of the kingdom. May grace and peace be to the marriages today. May grace and peace be to the families like never before in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, 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 Lord. I thank you because this grace and peace does not come, does not emanate from man. The grace and peace we are talking about does not come from a source that is diminishing. The grace and peace, my God, it comes from you, the source that cannot be diminished. And therefore, we are glad that, Lord, you are our source. You are our source in terms of grace and peace. You are our source. Ah, yes, yes, claim it. Claim grace and peace upon your life. Claim grace and peace upon your marriage. Claim grace and peace upon your church. Claim grace and peace upon your business. Claim grace and peace upon everything that is called by your name. Claim grace and peace. Yes, receive it today. Receive it today. Yes, as you are in a prayer closet, you see the goodness of is every time we pray, we become the first beneficiary of the blessing of God. Every time we pray, regardless of what we are praying for, we are the first beneficiary of everything that God is going to do, because God is praying through us. God is ministering through us. So this morning, even as you pray for grace and peace in different sectors, I want you to receive grace and peace from God. I want you to receive grace and peace from God for your life, for your family, for the work of your hands, for the church that you attend. Ah, yes, grace and peace. For your husband, if you're married, for your wife, for your father, for your mother, for your sons and daughters, both spiritual and biological, grace and peace. Even those that you seem as if they are not enjoying the peace of God at such a time as this, that's why we are in the prayer closet, and we are agreeing with Paul as he's writing to the Colossian church, and saying that may grace and peace, Lord, I receive grace and peace on behalf of my wife. I receive grace and peace on behalf of my husband. I receive grace and peace on behalf of my father. I receive grace and peace on behalf of my mother. I receive grace and peace on behalf of my son. I receive grace and peace on behalf of my daughter. I receive grace and peace on behalf of God of the church. Yes, I receive grace and peace. Receive, receive, receive from God. He says, may grace and peace be unto you from God the Father. The Father that when we ask for bread, he will not give us a stone. When we ask for fish, he will not give us a snake. When we ask for grace and peace, he will give us grace and peace. Receive it today, even as we begin to pray. Something good is coming your way. Yes, something spectacular is coming your way. Grace and peace. This morning, as you walk in this day, you are receiving grace and peace. Yes, in every situation, in a trying moment, in the storm, you are receiving grace and peace. God speaks to Paul and says that my grace is sufficient. Yes, you're praying that I remove this thing from your body, but my grace, he said three times, my grace is sufficient. My grace is sufficient. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And that's why you will be made stronger, even in difficult times. Receive grace. I receive grace. My God, this morning, I receive grace. I receive peace. The peace that surpasses all human understanding. I receive grace on behalf of my brother who is praying with me today. On behalf of my sister who is praying with me today. Lord, we receive grace. Lord, we receive grace and peace. Lord, we receive grace and peace in every circumstance that our country is facing. My God, we receive grace and peace in every circumstance that this church is facing. The church of my brother, the church of my sister who is joining with us in prayer today, we receive grace and peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, in advance for grace. Thank you, Lord, in advance for peace. Thank you, Lord, that the situation that was supposed to cause us to lack faith, it shall not overwhelm us because we have received grace and peace. The circumstances that came our way to dismantle our belief system, it shall not succeed because we receive grace and peace. Makalabadaya, I bless your name, my God. I give you praise because we are stronger today. As a church, we are stronger today. As a family, we are stronger today. As individuals, we are stronger today because we have received grace and peace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, I thank you in advance. I thank you in advance for grace and peace. I thank you in advance for grace and peace. I thank you in advance for grace and peace. Verse number 3 says, we always thank God. We are a thanksgiving church. We are a thanksgiving family. We are given to give thanks to God. Just thank God because you are in prayer. Thank God because you are receiving grace and peace. Thank God because every time you pray, you have an attitude of thanksgiving for what he has done, what he is doing, and for what God is yet to do in your life, in my life, in our lives. We thank God. Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We bless your name. We bless your name. Glory be unto your name. Praise be unto your name. Oh, blessed be. Blessed be your name. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you. We thank you for who you are, Lord. We thank you for what you've done, oh God. We thank you for what you continue to do in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Even in our prayer, when we remember one another in prayer, Lord, we thank you. When we remember one another in intercession, I thank you for my brother, my God. I thank you for my sister. I thank you for this church, my God. I thank you for this family. I thank you, my God, for this mother, for this father. I thank you, Jehovah God, for sustaining us in the prayer closet every other day. I thank you for connecting us in the spirit in the prayer closet every other day. I thank you, God, for enabling us to pray through every other day. I thank you for the testimonies that you keep on bringing our way. I thank you for the miracles that you keep on bringing our way. I thank you for the breakthroughs that you keep on bringing our way. I thank you, God, for the open doors you keep on showing us. I thank you for the opportunities that you keep on showing us. My God, I bless you. Come on, thank him. Thank him in advance. There are things that he does. Every time you remember a brother, thank God that he gives us the grace to be able to pray with them, to be able to call on God with them, to be able to declare things with them in the name of Jesus Christ. Paul is saying to the Colossian church that we always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you. Every time we pray for you, we are in a thanksgiving mode. We don't forget to praise God. We don't forget to lift up the name of Jesus. As a church, as a family of prayer believers, this morning we thank God as we pray for one another, as we pray for victory, as we pray for your healing, as we pray for a breakthrough, as we pray for an open door. We are dedicated to thank God. We are a grateful people. I know you are grateful for what God has done. You are grateful every time you pray for me, every time you pray for a brother, every time you pray for a sister. I know in your prayer you are grateful that God gives you the opportunity. And that's why this morning we cannot forget to thank God. We cannot forget to thank God for the things that he has done, for the things that he is doing, and for the things that is yet to do. We thank him. We thank him. And Paul continues to say, because we heard of your faith, I want us to believe God. Yeah, now we keep on. We are praying. Remember, we are praying the scriptures. If you have joined us today, we are in Colossians chapter number 1, right, verse number 4 now, that when we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus. When we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus, I want us to believe that we are men and women of faith. The Bible says, Paul is saying that we thank God for you. When we heard of your faith, I want us to believe. I want you to believe that when somebody hears of your faith, they are going to pray with you. They are going to thank God for you, and therefore build up your faith now. I want us to believe that our faith is growing stronger because of this pandemic. demonic. Male people, their faith is growing weaker because of the economic situation in their lives. Their faith is growing weaker. And maybe you're praying with us today and your faith is on a shaky ground. I'm praying with you. I'm praying with you that your faith is strengthened. That your faith is strengthened. You know, faith does not come because of experiences. If faith came because of experiences, the children of Israel could be men and women of faith, because they saw the Red Sea parting, they saw Jordan parting, they saw manna, they saw, the Bible says, even water came from the rock, and there was a rock that followed them. If there was faith was built because of experiences, there could be men and women of faith. But the Bible says that faith comes. Faith does not come through experiences. Experiences just help us to keep on believing in God. But faith comes by the word of God. Romans chapter 10 verse 17. Now faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So I pray. What we are praying is that I'm building my faith by hearing the word of God. I'm building my faith by reading the word of God. I'm building my faith by hearing God like never before. The Bible says that Paul is telling the church, when we heard of your faith, and we are praying this morning that somebody will hear of your faith. How will they hear it? As you're building it, as you're strengthening. Jude 20, it says, building up your most holy faith, praying in the spirit. So we are people, we are men of faith. We are strengthened in faith. Our faith is becoming stronger today than yesterday, in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you there with me? Let us pray. Let us pray for our lives. And as you pray for your life, please pray for a brother and a sister. There is somebody who is losing faith, but I believe that we can pray for one another to strengthen our faith, that God to strengthen our faith. The Bible says that the disciples one day told Jesus, increase our faith, increase our faith. Yes, we are weak, but increase our faith. Today we can pray for a brother. Today we can pray for a sister, for their faith to be strengthened. Their faith is on a shaky ground, but I believe that when we pray the scripture, that their faith is being strengthened in Jesus' name. Let's go for it. Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's go for it. Let's go for it. Start with your life. Talk to God about your faith situation. Talk to God about your faith situation. There are situations that maybe they have shaken your faith. But I believe that when we go to God, God is the ultimate. God ministers to us. God touches our life. God, I thank you. The Lord God, I thank you. I thank you for this morning. I thank you for my faith. I thank you for the faith of my brother. My God, this pandemic has shaken the faith of many. This pandemic has taken the faith away, the faith of many. This pandemic has made many not to believe in you the way they used to believe in you. Some of them thought they had faith. They realized that they didn't have faith in God. My God, as the months go by, as the days go by, as the issues, some of them even have decided that let it be. I'm not going to believe in God. I'm not going to believe in anything. I just allow life to take its course. But we are men and women that don't live by sight. The Bible says they just shall live by faith. Father, we join our faith together. We join in this prayer closet. We join our faith together. Praying, oh God, for the man, for the woman that is weak in faith, that their faith is on a shaky ground. My God, we know that when we ask, we shall receive. Father, we pray that strengthen our faith. Strengthen our faith. I pray for them, for the family of my brother, the family of my sister, that strengthen our faith. They have been hard hit economically, and their faith, oh God, is on a shaky ground. My God, I pray that strengthen their faith in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As Abraham did not waver, my God, I pray that they will not waver at the promise of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray, oh God, that strengthen their faith, strengthen her faith, strengthen his faith. My God, their job is on a balance, is on the edge, and they don't know what to do. My God, today I pray that strengthen their faith in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, to still believe in you, to still believe in your power, to still believe in your grace, to still believe in your enabling ability to take them out and to set them upon the solid rock in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Paul is saying, my God, that when I heard of your faith in Christ Jesus, my God, I pray that our faith in Christ Jesus shall not be eroded by this pandemic. Our faith in Christ Jesus shall not be eroded by an economic crisis. Our faith in the Lord Jesus shall not be eroded by the things of this world. Our faith in the Lord Jesus shall not be eroded by things that cause us to be disappointed. Our faith in the Lord Jesus shall not be eroded by the calamities of this world, by the trials and the tribulations. Our faith in the Lord Jesus shall be constant in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Paul is saying that when I heard of your faith, my God, I pray that generations after generations shall hear of our faith, shall hear of our faith, just the way Lois was full of faith, Eunice was full of faith, and Timothy caught the same kind of faith. My God, I pray that generations after generations shall hear of our faith in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for my brother, I pray for my sister at a tough time, a time as this, my God. I pray for this family that are going through a tough time and their faith is on a shaky ground. This marriage that is going through a tough time and their faith is on a shaky ground. This business that is going through a tough time and their faith is on a shaky ground. My God, today I pray, oh God, that for their faith, I pray for their faith in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, my God, that Lord, their faith shall still remain in the Lord Jesus Christ. That Lord, they shall not shift their faith to the systems of this world, because the faith in Christ Jesus is a faith of God that is on a solid ground. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for this pastor whose faith is on a shaky ground because of the issues concerning the church. I pray for the lady whose faith is on a shaky ground because of what is happening to the church. I pray, oh God, for this father, this mother, this son, this daughter, Makalabadia, this employee, this employer, whose faith is on a shaky ground. Father, this day, in this prayer closet, I lift them up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Matila, as they keep on reading the word, as they keep on hearing the word, may their faith be strengthened. May their faith be strengthened in Jesus' mighty name, as the disciples prayed and asked to increase their faith. Father, I pray with my brother, I pray with my sister, that increase our faith at such a time as this. Increase our faith at such a time as this. Multiply our faith at such a time as this. Yes, Lord. Yes, we pray with one another this day. We pray with one another that increase our faith. Increase the faith of the feeble. Increase the faith of the stronger. Increase the faith of our children. Increase the faith of our mothers, increase the faith of our fathers, increase the faith of our young people, increase the faith of those that have been employed, increase the faith of even those that have been rendered open, jobless right now. My God, I know that when we increase our faith, we shall see a way out of every situation. My God, Paul is saying, when I heard of your faith, may our faith be heard beyond borders. In Jesus' name, may the faith of my brother be heard beyond borders. May the faith of my sister be heard with beyond borders. May the faith of my mother be heard beyond borders. May the faith of our fathers be heard beyond borders. In Jesus' name, may the faith of the church be heard beyond borders. In Jesus' mighty name, may the faith of this businessman and woman be heard beyond borders. A faith that moves mountains. In the name of Jesus Christ, a faith that will attract prayer, faith that will attract intercession, faith that will attract breakthroughs, faith that will attract the miraculous, a faith that will attract a resurrection of everything that the enemy has taken away from their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you are growing in faith. Yes, even in this situation, even in the situation that you are in, I want granted to pray that God is increasing your faith. God is increasing your faith. God is increasing your faith. You are not coming out of this situation weaker. You are coming out stronger in the name of Jesus Christ. You are coming out better in the name of Jesus Christ. You are coming out rejuvenated in Jesus' name. God is increasing your faith. I say God is increasing your faith. God, increase our faith. Increase our faith. Increase the faith of my brother. Increase the faith of my sister. Increase the faith of this father, this mother. Increase the faith of this one whose job is on the line. My God, we are coming out better. We are coming out better because of our faith. In Jesus' name, strengthen, my God. Strengthen, my God. Lord, we, some of us are like that further who wanted healing. And Jesus said, if you believe, all things are possible. And he said, Lord, I believe, help my unbeliever. My God, I have a brother. I have a sister who is praying with me today, and he's saying, Lord, I believe, but help my unbeliever. I believe, but help my unbeliever. I believe, but help my unbeliever. I believe you're making a way, but help my unbeliever. I believe, my God, but there is a portion in me that keeps on disturbing me not to believe. My God, Lord, I pray with them. I pray with us. I pray with this family. I pray with this individual. I pray with this father, this mother. My God, help, help, my God. Increase our faith. Paul is saying in Colossians chapter number 1, verse number 4, because we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus, we are praying that our faith shall go before us. Your faith shall go before you. Your faith shall go before you. Yes, your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ will be heard by many, and they will be provoked to keep on praying with you. They'll be provoked to keep on trusting God with you. In Jesus' name, your faith is contagious in this season. Your faith in Christ Jesus is contagious. Yes, you can't be in a fix today, but God is causing your faith to be contagious. You can be in a fix in a trying moment right now, but our God, as we pray, God is increasing your faith. God is increasing your faith. God is increasing your faith, my brother. God is increasing your faith, my sister. Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Colossians chapter number 1 verse 4, because we heard of your faith, we keep on praying with you. I'm praying with you because your faith is going before you. Yes, it is not doubt. Doubt has been eradicated. Doubt has been eradicated. Even in this season, your faith is speaking. Your faith is speaking. Your faith is speaking in the name of Jesus Christ. And then he says, and of the love you have for all of God's people. Hallelujah. We are praying for love. We are praying for love, that we are men and women of love. We love God's people. We love one another. Every spirit of hatred has no part in our lives. Yes, he says that you do not only have faith, but also you have the love for God's people. Our men and women are rising in this generation that love one another. Let us love one another. Let us love one another. 1 Corinthians chapter number 13. If I can prophesy but have love, don't have love, I am nothing. Love is precious. Love is kind. Hallelujah. If you can open there so that you can be able to pray effectively. He says that you are men and women of love. You are men and women of love. That every time you pray, he says, I pray for you because you have faith, but I also pray for you because you are given to love. If you are given to love, 1 Corinthians chapter number 13, it says, if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but do not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. Verse number 13 says, and all this remain, faith, hope and love, but the greatest of this is love. So I want you to pray that you are a man and a woman of love. And there are several things that is claiming them. If I have a gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries, and I have faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. I want to declare that we are people of love. It says that I pray with you. I pray with you because you have faith, but I also pray with you because you have the love for all the people. You have the love for all the people. Verse number 4, 1 Corinthians chapter number 13, it says, love is patient. Love is kind. He does not envy. He does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecy, they cease. Where there are tongues, they will still cease. But love. I want you to pray. Are you lacking patience? Are you lacking kindness? Are you envious? Love is patient. Love is patient. I want you to pray. I want you to pray even as you connect with 1 Corinthians chapter number 13 that I'm a man, I'm a woman of love. I love God's people. I love God's people. It's interesting that even in church, we have people who hate one another. We have people who hate sinners. We have people who hate the saints. We have people who hate those who progress. But I want us to pray that as a church, we are men and women of love. Paul is saying that I always thank God for you because you have two things. One, you have faith. Number two, you have love for all of God's people. I want you to believe God that if you are lacking love, God is enabling you to start loving people, is enabling you to start being patient with people. Some of us are not patient with people. We are not even patient with ourselves. We are not kind, and we call ourselves believers. God is amazed that God so loved the world, and we are not loving the world. We are not loving the people that he has bestowed upon us. Some of us even don't love our own blood sisters and brothers. We claim that we love the Lord, yet we don't love the people that we see. John says, how can you love the Lord whom you don't see, and yet you love God? How can you claim you love God whom don't you see, and you don't love the people that you see? I want us to be people and men of love, people that love, people who are passionately to love one another, to build one another in Jesus' name. I'll take some time and pray. Take some time and pray. Love, 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 love. Come on, love, love. When somebody falls down, please, we need to love them and help them come up. When somebody goes astray, we need to love them. We need to pray them back into the kingdom. We need to pray them back into the kingdom. Praying them back to the kingdom. When somebody does not have food, we not only pray with them, but we go out of the way because we love them. We love the saints. We love the people. We can be able to provide for their need in Jesus' name. Paul is saying that I'm praying with you. I'm praying. Remember, we are praying the scriptures. First Colossians chapter number 1. I told you that praying the scriptures is sweet. It is so sweet. He says that I pray for you. I pray with you because you are men of faith, but you love God's people. Do you love God's people? I want you to start praying. Just start praying for yourself. Start praying for yourself. That Lord, give me that enablement. Lord, I know I have not been patient with God's people. I know I've not been kind with God's people. But you say in your word in 1 Corinthians chapter number 13, verse number 4, that love is kind. Love is patient. It does not envy. It does not boast. Lord, I know sometimes I've been envious of people's success. I've been envious of people's testimonies. But today I come. I am in the closet. It is you with God. It is you with God. Even as you pray today. Some of us have not been loving our parents. We have not even been loving our kids. Because when they fail, hatred is built up in us. We don't love the clergy. We don't love the church. We don't love our fellow members, sons and daughters in the kingdom, and we are amazed. How is it that God is not blessing me? But the love of God is not in our hearts. The greatest is love. God says, love the Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your mind, with all of your strength. Number two, you shall love your neighbor as you do yourself. I want you to go an extra mile and believe God that the same love you have for yourself, I believe that you love yourself. I want you to pray that you are a man, you are a woman that loves God's people. Heavenly Father, thank you that this morning there is a heart transplant. Your heart is our heartbeat. In the mighty name of Jesus, this morning we thank you, God, that we are men and women that hearken to the voice of God. We are men and women that hearken to the word of God. We are men and women that can be found in the house of men that are full of faith, men that have faith that move mountains, but men and women too that love God's people in Jesus' mighty name. The weak, we love the weaker. We love the stronger. We love those so that are progressing. We love those, oh God, that even have fallen, that we can go forth and pick them. We can still pray with them. We can still support them. In Jesus' mighty name, Father, I know we live in such a time, my God, that, Lord, it is so easy to hate on God's people. It is so easy to hate on those that are not doing the will of God. It is so easy to hate on those that are not passionate for prayer. And sometimes, my God, as those that are given to do the work of God, those that are given to serve, we seclude ourselves and we put ourselves, or we consider ourselves better than those ones. We consider ourselves better in praying, better in interceding, better in worship, better in praising, better in outreach, and we consider ourselves as family minus those that are doing the will of God. But today, my God, we pray, oh God, what Paul was talking to the church in Colossae concerning your love, that there were men and women that loved God's people. I pray that in our midst, in this congregation of prayer warriors, in this congregation of family that is given to prayer, that we are given to love on one another, that I love my sister, I love my brother, even when they are weak economically, my God, we still love them. That the environment does not take away the love we have for them. In Jesus' mighty name, we love God's people. We love God's people. My God, sometimes as a church, we have been tempted not to love the sinners, not to love those that to love also only the loyal people. But today we pray that we become the Colossian church that is able to love God's people regardless of what they do, regardless of what they do. Even sinners, that Lord, we are dedicated to love sinners as you love sinners, and you hate the sinner, you hate the action, but you love the person. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting love. You loved us when we were not performing. You loved us when we were not cleaner. You loved us when we were God. We could not prophesy. You loved us when we could not, oh God, sing for the kingdom. You loved us when we could not take care of our families. You loved us, oh God, when we were not living in our right senses. My God, the same love you are impacting upon our lives, that we are men of who love. We are women who love God's people. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that forgive us for the days, oh God, that when we were supposed to show love and we did not show love, and we lost a soul. We have lost souls because we did not love them the way you love them. We have lost husbands because we did not love them the way you love them. We have lost wives because we did not love them the way you love them. We have lost sons and daughters to the world because we did not love them the way you loved us. We have lost parents to the world because we did not love them the way you love them. We have lost saints in church. They are wounded. Most of them are wounded. Some of them even are praying with us today because they were not loved the way you love them, my God, and they are wounded. Forgive us as a church. Forgive us as a people. Forgive us as a congregation for not loving your people the way you love them, my God. My God, I pray, if there is one, oh God, who is praying with us this morning and they have been wounded because they fell short of your glory, they were not loved the way you love them, my God. My God, we ask, oh God, for healing. We ask for healing. We love them. We love them today. I want you to know, if you are there and you have been wounded, you have been wounded, you are not loved. Yes, you fell. Yes, you did something and you are not loved the way, you are not restored in love. I want you to believe God for healing right now, because God is restoring you. God loves you, and God commands us to love you. We love you with the love of Christ. We love you. You can still walk, you can still rise in Jesus' name. You can still rise, yes, in Jesus' name. I'm praying with you, I'm praying with you for your healing right now. I'm praying with you because this love brings healing, this love brings restoration. And I want you on your part, if you are that person, I want you to release the people that did not love you the way that you are supposed to be loved. You felt you are not loved the way God loves you. You felt betrayed. Yes, you say, yes, I mess. But these people also did not love me back. They did not reach out to me. I want you to open up your heart and say, Lord, I release them. I release them. I release them. I choose to love them back. Yes, they did not love me, but I choose to love them back. I choose to become this church. In Colossians, that you love God's people. I love God's people. I love God's people. I take away every hurt. I take away every pain. I release myself. Lord, I thank you because there is healing today. There is healing to the body of Christ because we love one another. There is healing to the body of Christ because we love the saints. We love the congregation. We love even those that have had heartbreaks in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Paul is praying and says that the church has faith and the church is full of love. Is full of love. Yes, from today, a new heart has been created. A new mindset has been created. A new mindset has been created. We are among those that love God's people. We are among those that are dedicated to pursue the will of God, the will of the Father. In Jesus' name, he says that these people have faith in God. These people have love for all the saints. In Jesus' name, church, we are praying that we are among those that are full of faith, are full of faith. Number two, we are among those that are full of the love of God. If you are joining us, we are in Colossians chapter number one, verse number four, that we are men and women of love. We love God's people. We love God's people. Do you love God's people? Are you short of the love of God? God can give you that love. Are you short of the love of, especially the people who are not loyal to you? Are you full of the love of God? As we are praying, you see God is changing our hearts as a church. We are the church. Those who are not with us are expecting us to give the love of God to them. Maybe they are not coming to the morning glory. Maybe they are not there in the lunch hour. Maybe they are not logging in as you expect them to log in. And sometimes you feel betrayed. Sometimes you feel that I cannot love those people. God is saying, God is telling us, church, we can still love them. We can still love them. If you are there, your pastor, and maybe they are not supporting your ministry, God is saying we can still love them. You are there, you are a departmental leader, and you feel that these people are letting me down. God is saying we can still love them. We can still love them. You are there and you feel you don't have the support you have as a husband, as a wife, as a father, as a mother, as a boy, as a child, as a son and daughter of that house. God is saying we can still love our parents. We can still love our wives. We can still love our husband. We can still love the people that don't bring us much delight. We can give them the love of God in the name of Jesus Christ. So tell God, God, help me. Help me in this season. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Verse number 5, it says, the faith and love that spring from the hope stored up in you in heaven. There is a hope. We do this because there is a hope that is stored up in us. We do this as a family, but because there is a hope that is stored up in us. Yes, in the name of Jesus Christ, we love them. In Jesus' name, our hearts, our lives are given to God to love God's people because there is a hope that is stored up in us in heaven. Yes, it says in verse 5, the faith and love that spring from the hope stored up for you in heaven, about which you have already heard the true message of the gospel that has come to you. Hallelujah. We do this because we have a hope. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There are several things. Verse number nine, he says that for this reason, since that day we heard about you, have not stopped praying for you. I want us to go ahead and pray that scripture, that we are not going to cease to keep on praying to pray for people. We're not going to cease to keep on praying for our husband, to keep on praying for our families, our wives, our sons, our daughters, our parents, the church. We're not going to cease pray. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians that we should pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 17, pray without ceasing. Luke chapter number 18, that men ought to pray and not to faint. I want you to pray that even as we go to the tail end of this broadcast that we are not going to cease. We are not going to cease. We are not going to cease. Act to pray. You are not going to cease. In the mighty name of Jesus. Verse number 9. First Colossians chapter number 1. Verse number 9. For this reason, since we heard, we do not stop praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of His will through all wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives. That you are not going to cease to pray. Number 2, you are going to pray that there will be filled with the knowledge of God's will through all wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives. My prayer to them, I shall not go out, shall not diminish. I will not cease to pray with you. I will not cease to pray for your family. I will not cease to pray for us as a people. We will not cease to pray for our country. We will not cease to pray for the congregation that God has given to us. We will not cease to pray for our children. We will not cease. What will we be praying? We will be praying that they will be filled with the knowledge of God, with the knowledge of God, with the wisdom of God, with the wisdom of God. We will not cease to pray, to pray, to pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, yes, we are continuing in prayer this week. We are continuing in prayer this month. We are continuing in prayer this year in Jesus' mighty name. I want you to pray for your life that you are not among those that give up in prayer. You are not among those that give up in intercession. You are not among those that give up in calling on heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, I love it when we pray the prayer. I love it when we pray the scriptures. I love it when we pray the scriptures. Because when we do, we realize there are so many things that the scripture is talking to us. And there are so many things that we are tapping in. Come on, pray, pray, pray for yourself. Pray for yourself that I am not ceasing. Pray for somebody else that they are not ceasing to pray. They are not ceasing. We are a people that are connected in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, for this reason, since we heard about you, when you hear about me, when I hear about you, when you hear about a family, when you know a family, when you know a church, you will not cease to pray with them. Come on, church. We are among those that pray for one another. We are among those that pray for one another because I know so and so, because I know you. When I am in prayer, I remember you, because I know a family. When I am in prayer, I remember that family. Even in this pandemic, I want you to understand that there is a family that is waiting for your prayer, and therefore you cannot cease to pray for them. There is a marriage that is waiting for your prayer. You cannot cease to pray for them. There is a person who is logging in right now as we are praying, and they are waiting for your prayer. I want you to pray that I will not cease to pray for my fellow prayer mates in the morning glory. I will not cease to pray for men and women that join us every other time. I will not cease to pray for my blood brothers and sisters. I will not cease to pray for my parents. I will not cease to pray for my church. I will not cease to pray for my brothers and sisters in the Lord. In Jesus' name. And what will you be praying? That God will continually fill them with knowledge. People are being filled with knowledge because we are not ceasing. The Bible says, according to His will, through all wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I keep on praying. I pray for you. I pray for you that God will continually fill you with knowledge. That God will continually fill you with knowledge. That God will continually fill you with knowledge in His will, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that may it begin today in the name of Jesus Christ. May that knowledge begin today in Jesus' name. God, fill my brother, fill my sister. I pray with them today. Fill them with knowledge of your will as the Spirit gives understanding and wisdom in every matter they tackle today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I pray that may it become a reality today. May it become their testimony today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May you cause them to experience tangible results because of the filling in of your knowledge in your will in Jesus' name. Tangible results in the marketplace, tangible results in their families, tangible results in the work of their hands, tangible results in the church, tangible results where they are. I pray for you, my brother, my brother. I pray for you, my sister, today. In Jesus' mighty name, let there be an infilling right now. In Jesus' mighty name, let there be an infilling right now. As we join together in prayer, my brother, my sister, I pray with you, let there be an infilling of the knowledge of God. Let there be a divine deposit into your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you will know what you ought to do in every hour because of the knowledge of God upon your life. In Jesus' name, this day is not a waste because of the knowledge of God in your life. This hour is not a waste because of the knowledge of God in your life. Yes, where you did not know what to do, when, I believe that from today, the infilling of knowledge from the Most High is paving a way where there seems to be no way, in the name of Jesus Christ. I bless you. I bless you. Take a few minutes and just thank him for what he has done. There's so much to pray in Colossians chapter number 1. But we are limited with time. But I want you to keep on praying this prayer. I want you to keep on reading the scriptures even as you pray. In the name of Jesus, thank him. Thank him for what he has done already. Thank him for what he has done in your life. Thank him for increasing your faith. Thank him for increasing your dimension of love. Thank him. Thank him for filling you up. Thank him for releasing the pain that was in your life. Has been taken away because you have released people. Somebody has just released people. Somebody has just been healed today. Somebody has just been delivered today. I want you to thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Blessed be your name, oh God. This day is gonna be fruitful because somebody's life has become better than yesterday, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. We honor you. We give you praise. We give you adoration, oh God. You are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, I thank you for being with us. I thank you for your guidance. I thank you for your leadership. Thank you for the healing. Thank you for the restoration. Thank you for the touch from above. Thank you, God, that every bitterness that was upon my brother, my sister, has been taken away. Every pain because of rejection, every pain because of not being loved, oh God, has been taken away. My God, I thank you. I thank you for doing a work in the lives of men and women this morning. Thank you for enlightening concerning your love in our lives, oh God. Jesus, blessed be your name. Thank you for filling, the filling of knowledge according to your will. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are better. Father, I pray that as we leave this prayer closet today, may your spirit keep on speaking to us, keep on ministering to us, to the glory and honor of your name. This day is blessed. This day, your favor shines in our lives and through our lives. This day, oh God, we see the Lord high and lifted up, and the glory of God fills the house, fills the temple, in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak the blessing of God over my brother. I speak the blessing of God over my sister. I speak the blessing of God over this family, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I declare that they are above only and not beneath. In Jesus' name, this day they walk in power. This day they walk in might. This day they walk in the wisdom and the knowledge of God. I declare that the open doors upon your life, in Jesus' name. I declare an open heaven over your life, in Jesus' name. I declare protection, the security of God over your life, in Jesus' name. Everywhere you go today, you are covered, you are covered, you are covered, you are covered, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. I commend you to God and to the word of his grace that will able to build you up and give you an inheritance among those who are sanctified. I give you praise, O God. I give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. God favor you. May his face shine towards you. May he give you peace. Remember, there's so much we have not tackled today in Colossians chapter number 1 that we need to pray with. There's a part of being strengthened with all power and might. There's so much. So I want you to keep on praying, to keep on praying, to keep on reading that scripture and pray for your life. Pray for your life. What we are doing in the morning is just igniting the fire of praying the scriptures this week. Igniting the fire of praying the scripture. We might not finish the whole scripture, but I want you to get the same grace and just move in even as you pray the scriptures concerning your life. God bless you. God favor you. May his face shine towards you. You are the blessed of God. You are the favored of God. This is your day. Expect the miraculous in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's meet tomorrow, 5:30 a.m. East African time. Shalom, shalom. God bless you. We love you. Amen.